I'm Adam Steinfurth. This is the Prolific Oak Tree Channel, and we're going to take 10 minutes and show you how to use Apple Numbers. So Apple Numbers is the spreadsheet that comes free with every Mac computer. So you already have it, it's already installed. So let's click on it to fire it up. And what we're going to do is we're going to start with a new document. So there's nothing in this spreadsheet yet. So I clicked on new document and we're going to use just blank, because that way you'll understand some of the things that are going on in the other templates, right? So get some of the basics down here. So we will click on create, and it gives us a blank spreadsheet, and every spreadsheet consists of lettered columns and numbered rows. So what that allows you to do is describe where data is located. So if you want to reference something that's right here, let's say surrounded by green borders, and you refer to this as cell D6. And here we go. So we have a blank canvas. And what we want to do is we're going to make a quick inventory ledger, and we're going to have cells B1, C1, D1. Those are going to be headers. So let's go into B1 and let's say item name. We will say where it's a hardware store. So we will say we're selling wheelbarrows. We're doing nails and screws, and that's all. Small hardware store. Press enter. And there's a couple concepts here that you're seeing already that are important. And one of them is that row one and column A were pre-formatted for you as headers. Usually kind of handy, but in this case, I don't want the item name to look like a header. So that's why I put it in column B. So what we can do with that is this formatting is controlled at the table level. So we'll come over to this formatting side pane. If here we have one header row, which we've used, and I like that one, we'll keep that one. But I don't want the column to be a header. So we're going to change that to 0. And we'll come back and look, and it took that weird highlighting off of column A. And what you can do, and watch what happens here. So if I right click and do delete column, that will shift everything to the left. So what was in B2 is now in A2. Okay, same data. All right, now that we cleaned up the formatting, let's just make up some quantities. Just one screw, not a lot in there. And some prices, we'll say 245. That's a cheap wheelbarrow. We'll say 219 cents, and then we'll say 119 and 25. All right, so now we have this built out a little bit. So when we look at this data that we filled out, there's some important things going on with it. It's helpful to understand from the beginning. And one is that you're looking at two different types of data here. You're looking at text, so that is these labels. And then you're also looking at numbers. And yeah, that might seem obvious, but one thing to keep in mind is that when you're using formulas, which we will in a little bit, you can manipulate numbers, but usually not text, right? So when we sum these values, it's not going to make sense to sum these. And that's a concept that'll keep rearing its head as you use spreadsheets. It seems obvious now, but it's good to understand it. And one way to start kind of understanding what that means is, let's highlight this range. So what I'm doing, I take my mouse, I hold the button down, and I select all of these rows. I'm actually doing it with a trackpad right now, which you could also do it with a keyboard. So I'm using my arrow keys. I hold down the shift key, and I go down to, and I've highlighted a range. So that's referring to three cells at one time. But because I've highlighted it, when you come down to the bottom, it's giving you some quick data about it. But the only formula, the count A formula here, that's working is count A. And that's because that counts the non-blank cells. So that's getting a three. It's saying, hey, there's three values there. But because these are text and not numbers, none of these other functions are doing anything that's helpful. So let's highlight the numbers instead. And you come down to the bottom and you get all these helpful summaries. So those add up to 33, the average 11, etc. But those will disappear as soon as you select something else. Although those are helpful, they're not the final way that you want this data presented. So what you want to do is insert a formula into a cell. So let's say we happen to know that there's only going to be three lines on here. One thing you could do to make your spreadsheet really tight and nice looking too, which is important, right? Let's delete the empty rows and then make this last row. We left one empty row. We're going to make that last row a footer. So we'll say there's one footer here. So now that I have the active cell below a column of numbers, what we're going to do is insert our first formula. And after you're using spreadsheets for a while, you just start a formula by tapping the equals key, and then it brings up that formula editor. But we're going to do it the more, I'd say, beginner's way. I guess it's the more, it gives you more help when you do it this way. We'll go to insert, and then we will say new formula. And then you get this box over here where you can search for formulas, and you want to sum the data, right? So when you type in sum over here, you get to read about it and see how it works. And even an example here. So the equal sign, like we said, and then sum, and then the range for where the data is. And that happens to be the right range. I wonder if it knew that. Okay, so we will then double click. Well, we will say insert function. And now it's waiting for the value. So we'll click into the value and we will just type out, it's easy that way, B2 through, which is the colon, B4. We'll hit enter and now you have a 33, but it's not like you saw it at the bottom when you just highlighted it temporarily, because if I move out of that cell, it stays there. Now we are going to do another way to write a formula. But first we're going to change this formatting. So this is a price, this is currency. It's still a number, but I want to present it differently. So what we will do is change the formatting on just some of the cells. So we'll go to the cell section, and instead of automatic data formatting, we will say currency. And because I'm in the US, I guess all of this should be in dollars. And we will come here, and just to make it different, let's say we want to do the average price instead of the sum of the prices. And now we will just type, we'll hit the equal sign, and we'll type AV, and one of these guesses is correct. We want to do average. And now for the value, let's do something different and just type price. And that brings up one of the column headers right here. And I can tell that that's my label because it's not all capitalized. And that selected the entire column. We will click the green check mark to accept the changes and close. And now we have our second formula. Now let's talk about how to easily copy this formula to subsequent cells. So let's just say we have another column and it's weight. And the wheelbarrow is 100, whatever the units is. Let's say ounces, nails are 2, screws are 1. If you don't want to keep retyping the formula, but it's the same one, if you come over to a cell, in this case C5, that has the formula you want, you just need to move it one to the right. When you click that, when you hover over the cell, you will get a yellow dot on the side that you're on. Click and drag that over one, let go, and that will copy the formula to the right, but it will adjust the cell reference to get the new column. All right, and let's touch on one more topic before the 10 minutes is up. This is a beautiful spreadsheet, right? But a lot of times you want more than one, but let's say it's inventory related, so you want it in the same file. You can insert another table on the same sheet. So this is table 2, this is table 1, or you can do an entirely new sheet. But when you're referencing back and forth between these sheets, there's a special way to do it. And this next video is going to talk all about referencing cells in Apple Numbers. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned a lot. I'll see you in the next video.